Hi folks, Kim Schofield here, back with another video on my YouTube channel. Thank you so much for joining me and for visiting. I am happy to have you here and excited about today's project. So this is a project for the Joggles design team, and it is featuring some of these metal embellishments from Frank Morrow. So these are good side. They're heavy, heavy duty metal. These are not like a thin, you know, sheet metal that you could bend easily. They're pretty substantial. You do want to wash them when you get them because they have a little bit of residue on them. So you want to wash that off with soap and water. And I have a few pieces here. I got a bunch of these in my design team kit. And these are, they are so much fun. I absolutely love them. So many different ideas and projects that you can make with them. And you can see they're a pretty good size. This is probably about, the butterfly here is probably about a 2-inch by 2-inch butterfly. So real good size. Same with the dragonfly and the star. And then the chicken down here, which I had to use the chicken, so much fun. I love chickens. This is probably about 4 to 5 inches wide. So pretty good size. So as you can see, I am applying a layer of gesso onto all of these because I want to paint with them. You actually can also use alcohol inks on top of these. So if you had a felt with one of those felt pieces with a blending tool, you could apply some alcohol inks like you would get from Ranger. And but I decided I wanted to do paint, so I did put down a layer of gesso first. I will say that if you were to scratch these, you probably could scratch the paint off. So it didn't help too much, but it certainly made my acrylic colors pop. So I have here a piece of wood that I just got from my local, kind of the big box store. And I have some distress stain. This is a vintage photo color. And I am simply putting it on top of the wood. I am not, I didn't treat the wood, didn't sand the wood, didn't do anything. This is something that's probably about 80 cents. For me to buy this piece of wood. I will say I was inspired by some folk art that I saw on Pinterest, and there was something I saw that was done on a piece of wood, and I thought it was really cool, and that it would be perfect to use with these metal pieces. And so that was kind of my starting point. And this is just a piece of pine, I think, something like that, that I got. It soaks up the stain really well. You could add a second coat if you wanted to, which I ended up doing. And then I kind of thought, I let it dry. I hit it with a heat tool a little bit, let it dry. And I didn't really like the color once everything was kind of dried and soaked into the wood. You can see I wanted it much more brown. And so what I had was kind of that yellow green. So I switched to distress paint. So I'm putting some of the paint on, and I'm using a baby wipe actually to apply the color. Now, you're gonna wanna move that paint pretty quickly because it will soak right into the wood because there's no gesso. You can see I have some little spots there. Just that quickly, the paint kind of started to soak into the wood. So that's why I'm using a wet, you know, a paper towel, not a wet paper towel, I'm sorry, a baby wipe to put that on. And then I decided I really like the other side. So I'm getting a little bit wetter. You can see here, once I get the baby wipe, I'm able to blend that a little bit more. So I liked the color more on the bare wood than I did going over the stain. So I really wanted that brown. No surprise there, me and my brown. I love brown. So that's what I ended up doing instead of using kind of that the yellowy kind of look on the other side. And what I found was if it started to get harder to blend that paint, look at that great green in the wood too. You just got another baby wipe, went back in, and you could spread that really easy. So no, I did dry that. I set it aside to dry and I hit it with the heat tool. And now we are going to be doing some painting. So this is just the background, mostly Dina Wakely, because I want a nice heavy body paint. And so that's what I'm going in with first, because again, no gesso, this is going to soak into the wood. Of course, there is a little bit of layer of paint there, so that's going to help some, but it's not like if I had gessoed everything first. So it is going to, you know, your colors are going to kind of be muted down a little bit because it's going on top of that brown. And then of course there's no gesso there, so it's going to soak in a little bit. This is my new camera setup here. So you see a little bit more of my junk off to the side than you used to, like my water and the paints and stuff. Still working through that in my new space. So with my paint, I'm just creating, you know, kind of the illusion of sky, ground, grass, that kind of thing. Just working that in, adding more layers. I don't want to completely cover up the wood. In the middle, I don't mind it covered, but I want that wood peeking out on the top and the bottom. So I'm not going all the way to the top. And this is really challenging for me not to, you know, really paint everything and cover everything perfectly to kind of have a sloppier look on the edges. I was a little stressed about it, but it actually ended up working out fine. And I loved the finished piece. I really liked it. I kind of found a pouncing motion with the brush actually gave me a little bit better coverage than if I was swiping the brush back and forth, just because I got a little bit more of that, you know, you could see those brush marks a little bit more because I'm working on a piece of wood instead of paper, but just kept kind of fooling around with that until I was happy. And now I'm going to paint my metal pieces. So painting my chicken, I am making my chicken a barred rock. So if you have chickens, you'll know what kind of chicken that is. I used to have chickens and we had some of these and we loved them. And so that's what my chicken is going to be. And you can see the great coverage by putting that gesso down, how that paint is sticking onto the metal. It works great and the colors really pop. So to do the dragonfly and the butterfly, I'm actually using a stenciling brush. So very stiff, short bristles. And that enables me to kind of pounce on that color, especially because it's a little bit smaller space. And so that's what I'm doing. So just adding some, you know, colors around on the wings there. And so by adding the paint, you know, I'm adding this blue with the purple that's not quite dry. And I got some awesome blending, really turned out really nice on the dragonfly and the butterfly. I was really happy with that. So just picking up a little pink there for my butterfly. That was a great combo with the orange and the purple, and that worked out really well. Again, I apologize for you seeing all my mess off to the side there. What my table really looks like. But yeah, it's a little messy. I'll have to work on that a little bit to get a little better viewing area. I have a much smaller table now. I've kind of rearranged everything. So I decided to go for some white splatters here, and you can see they were gigantic. They were a little large, but I was able to kind of knock them back, and I like the way it ended up, actually. So now for my barred rock, I'm finishing them off. Barred rock, they're black chickens, and they have these little white specks on them. And so I'm just using a white gel pen, and the chicken has some indentations in the metal. So all I did was follow those little indents with the white gel pen, and it looked perfect. I love the way it turned out. It looks really, really cool. And I did use some red paint to paint the some parts on the chicken there, his little wattle up on top, and or maybe that's on the bottom, the comb and the wattle. Painted that red and painted the beak and the feet there, just using some other paint colors. So adding a little bit of white onto my butterfly and dragonfly and setting those aside. So this is completely dry, my painted surface, and it was looking like it needed some more stuff in the background. So out came, of course, chicken wire background stamp from Tim Holtz. Had to add that. And I am using a black archival. And that is because I'm going on top of paint. You don't want to use any kind of dye ink or distress ink. I mean, you can, but, you know, it may not dry that well. It's not going to be as vibrant, and it could react with water if it ever got wet. So this is also kind of a nonsense script stamp from Tim Holtz. And I'm just adding, you know, here and there. Occasionally putting my metal pieces onto the wood to, you know, kind of decide where I want to place things. And then I also have this number stamp from Wendy Vecchi. I love this stamp. I put it on everything. just a combination of text and numbers to me is fabulous. And so all I'm doing is really creating some layers with this. I do like to layer when you're just having background stuff here. Where you're not trying to do anything really deliberate. This is just designed in the background. I really like to layer them. So I've got my chicken wire layered with my text, layered with my numbers. And then this is a little stitched stamp from Wendy. And I kind of like the idea of this, kind of those little half circles there on some of the parts of the wood there. Kind of looks like it's, you know, there's some stitching. I think I bought this entire stamp set from Wendy simply because it had some little stitched stamps in it. Love it. And so I will heat set that to make sure all of that is dry. So adding a little bit more, I wasn't sure. I felt like I really wanted some kind of floral image at the bottom. And I have this nice stamp from Wendy Vecchi, and it's very thin lined stamp. So it's very subtle, very soft image, and it is perfect. It was like exactly what I wanted there in the background, almost like, you know, grasses or something at the bottom. And I really like the way that looked. And so again, you want to make sure all of that is dry. You want to heat set that archival. That's what's going to make it permanent. You don't want any smears. Now I'm going to sand the edges of my wood and even some of the paint. I apologize for the shaking there. So this is a sanding block from Tim Holtz, and I'm just sanding the daylights out of the edges, and you can kind of see some of that wood come through. Really like that kind of rustic, distressed look. Really more along the edges, working that along the edges. So I decided I needed some clouds, and I actually practiced on the other side of my board before I committed here because I thought, oh my gosh, I'm putting white paint right on top of everything. But I really liked it. Found that using this sponge did the best job of making clouds, and I just have a little bit of gesso pouncing that on there. And again, placing my metal objects to decide where I want them. I ended up not using the black star. I just could not decide what I wanted to do. I love the star, but it just did not fit with my butterfly and the dragonfly. So I'm using some gel medium. This is from the Crafters Workshop. Now these are kind of, like my chicken is a little, not hollow, but it's pushed in, you know, on the back side. So there's not a lot of places to add any kind of glue or tape. And so what I did was add this gel medium around the edges of the chicken and anywhere that was flat. And then I put something heavy on top of it, and it worked like a charm, held really well. And then I have some of these Tim Holtz, these words. I think these are relatively new. And I really like this idea about take the scenic route, which I just thought was kind of fun with, this kind of farm looking home decor piece. And I did cut it apart. So these are very thick cardboard, but using those Tim Holtz scissors, I was able to cut it apart, no problem, because it was too long to fit on my board the way it was. And so I just cut the words apart to put there. And I had a little glue squishing out, and I am just using a little, you know, craft pick and just scraping away some of that glue, but it will dry clear. This, you won't see it once it's dry, and it dries really quickly. So just having something heavy, the dragonfly on top of that, it's already stuck down and looking good. And then the last thing I wanted to do was add a little trail coming from the dragonfly and the butterfly, and I'm just hand drawing that. And then when I finished that, I kind of felt like that upper corner was a little lacking, so I added one more Tim Holtz, one of those little word pieces that he has. And that is about it for my project. Quick and easy, so much fun. Please check out the Joggle store and these wonderful metal embellishments. I know that you will find so many uses for them. Please share, leave a comment, give me thumbs up, and subscribe. Thank you so much.